A police officer sends a letter to LeBron James regarding LeBron's controversial tweet. A man beat the system by wearing, but not wearing a mask. And finally, I would give you my take on Mortal Kombat on HBO Max. I'm Luke Crotzer, and this is the Luke Crotzer Show. Before this video begins, I would like to remind you that if you have not yet subscribed to my YouTube channel, I encourage you to do so. And while you're at it, click the little bell icon so that you won't miss any of my newest content. Alright, on with the show. So we all know about the 16-year-old girl who got shot by a police officer for wielding a knife and attempting to stab someone with it. The officer saved the girl seconds before getting stabbed. However, because of a testimony from a guy Bryant's mother, the person who got shot, the media took it as another form of police brutality. Even after they sent out the body cam footage of the whole thing, it didn't stop the media from initially editing out the knife from the girl's hand. Not all networks did this, but a good number of them have. And they ended up talking about it in a way that would impact the cop in a negative way. With that said, I'm not trying to cover that. What I really wanted to talk about was how everyone was reacting to it, specifically LeBron James. Not only is the media trying to make this look bad, but also NBA All-Star LeBron James decided to comment on the situation. Recently, he sent out a tweet regarding the video saying in all caps, quote, "You're next," and he even posted a picture of the cop. The tweet is no longer on The tweet is no longer on LeBron's Twitter account. He deleted it after the backlash it received. However, even after LeBron found out that the police officer was indeed, in fact, saving someone's life, he still didn't apologize for what he said. However, in response to the tweet, an LA cop named Dion Joseph decided that he wanted to educate LeBron on police policies in a letter that Mr. Joseph personally wrote. After Dion sent the letter, it went viral immediately, and I actually wanted to read it to you personally. "Dear LeBron, I am not going to come at you from a place of hatred. There will be no name calling. I was raised to see the whole of a human being, not to hyper-focus on their flaws or make said flaws the whole of who they are. I'm an honest man. What you do for children and other acts of charity shows a huge heart. You show to be a family man, and that's to be respected. You play for the team my family has cheered since the 1960s, then myself since 1979. But your current stance on policing is so off-base and extreme. Your tweet that targeted a police officer in Ohio who saved a young woman's life was irresponsible and disturbing. It showed a complete lack of understanding of the challenge of our job in the heat of a moment. You basically put a target on the back of a human being who had to make a split-second decision to save a life from a deadly attack. A decision I know he and many others wish they had never made, especially when it involves someone so young." And then it continues saying, "I don't know if this will ever reach you, but my hope is that one day I can sit down with you and talk. As a man of faith, I can have no hatred toward you, but I do feel I can help you understand the reality of the profession of policing, and that there is no, and that there is another side you need to hear. You're tired of black folks dying? So am I. You hate racism and police brutality? So do I. But you cannot paint 800,000 men and women who are of all races, faiths, sexual orientations, and are also mothers, fathers, sons, daughters, preachers, coaches, community members, and just human with such a broad and destructive brush." And then the letter concludes with saying, "The offer's on the table, LeBron. No cameras, no fanfare, just two men who care talking. I know it's a long shot, but this division and hatred must stop. It's clear based on rising crime in marginalized communities that cops and the community need to build bridges to save lives on all sides. That cannot be done due to demonization of any group of people. Just putting it out in the universe, brother. Even if not me, please take the time to talk to a police officer instead of judging them. No shade. Thanks for all the positive things you do." And that's how it ends. I gotta say, this is a very well-written response. If you guys actually do want to read the full letter to this, I did put in the link in the description below, so go check that out. But I do want to say this before we continue any further, and y'all knew this was coming. From what we got from the footage, this cop was clearly trying to do his job, and he was clearly doing what he thought was right at the time. Yeah, you guys gotta remember, the time frame of the event was 9 seconds tops. So put yourself in his shoes when you watch the footage of the guy. What would you have done? Shoot, or let the girl get stabbed. It's a very unfortunate situation. Okay, so this segment's gonna be a little more chill. So while I was scrolling through Facebook, where you should follow me, by the way, I managed to find a video that I thought was incredibly hilarious. The video takes place in 2020, and it's about a man named Justin Flom, or Justin Flom. Either way, it's that. So Justin decided that he didn't want to wear a mask anymore, and he was able to beat the system by avoiding the mask mandates by, instead of wearing a mask, he decided to paint a mask on his face. Yeah, it's about to be insane. Here's actually the whole video of that situation.
The shopping trip I've ever done because I'm scared.
What's important though is that I am staying 6 feet away from everyone.
Right.
Like I'm staying away.
Because like when you go to a restaurant, you can sit down and take it off because you're actually 6 feet away.
Also, you know what worries me is that no one's really stopping. Like if this if this is the measures that are going to save lives and nobody's stopping, that's kind of weird, right?
Now I gotta say, I got mad respect for this guy. I mean, he's willing to paint his face just so he didn't have to wear a mask. I mean, talk about dedication. Now, realistically, if I ever tried this, I would have been caught right away. And I say that because, believe it or not, I happen to have a very big mouth. And, well, if I even said one thing, people would have figured me out immediately. I will say my favorite part of the video, though, is definitely when the security guard showed up to take a picture of him. Moral of this entire segment is, if you guys don't want to wear a mask anymore, well, you can just paint one on your face. So recently, I just saw the HBO MAX original, Mortal Kombat, and I gotta say, it was pretty good. As I predicted in my trailer time video, it was actually going to be a little more story-based and have a lot better CGI than the original. One thing I really did like was how the movie was able to add the cool little references in the OG game. We got Scorpion's iconic,
"Get over here!"
We got the fatality scenes. Iconic, the
flawless victory,
and so many more references that I can't put into one video. I think the movie is good. It's just the fact I think there's a few things that I feel like they could have done a little better. For starters, I'm really mad that they killed Khan Lao. I mean, they might bring him back in the sequel, but I'm still pissed off about it. I'm happy they gave him a flawless victory scene, but they still shouldn't have killed him. I was just beginning to like this guy. Another part of the movie I was a little confused about was Scorpion showing up out of nowhere to kill Sub-Zero when he was about to kill Cole. I mean, from what it looked like in the movie, Scorpion could have shown up like any time to kill Sub-Zero, but he chose that moment to do it. He literally could have been able to save Cole's family from being put on ice. Just saying. And my final critique about this movie is definitely the ending. From what it looks like, we will most likely be getting a sequel to this movie. But the problem is that the main character has already killed off the most popular bad guys from the game, so who are the new bad guys going to be? I mean, they could bring him back to life, but to me that's just lazy writing. But I am happy that we are going to be able to see Johnny Cage in the next film. Looking forward to that. I can tell a lot of OG Mortal Kombat fans are looking forward to that too. And despite the flaws that the movie had, the movie was still pretty awesome. It's definitely one of my top favorite movies for 2021, and I cannot wait for the sequel. I'm going to be rating this movie a 9 out of 10. Well guys, that is our show for today. As a reminder, if you did enjoy today's content, be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share to a friend. I'm on a slow run to 100 subscribers, so let's see if we can try to get there during the summertime. With that said, you've been a wonderful audience, and I bid you a good day. I'm Luke Crotzer, and this is the Luke Crotzer Show. Peace out, guys.